Welcome to Lumbridge Knight's Guide for the Demon Slayer Quest. All you really need for this quest is one coin and the ability to defeat a level 27 demon and survive his cohort of dark wizards. All the rest of the stuff can be picked up on the quest. Will this be the end of Dervil Iron? Well met, adventurers. I am the Lumbridge Knight, your guide to all things old school RuneScape. Remember to like and subscribe if you don't want to miss out on any of the hints, tips, tricks, and guides that I'll be bringing you on this channel. Blessings of Saradomin be upon you as we venture forth. So, it's time once again for another free-to-play old school RuneScape quest. This time, we're doing Demon Slayer. Now, you can start the quest by speaking to Gypsy. She is in the southwest area of Varrock Square. You can see it on the map there. You need to have one coin in your inventory and just speak to her in order to start the quest. She will ask you to cross her palm with silver, hence why we needed the coin. Once you do, we will get some like mad fortune telling thing where she tells us that Delrith, an evil demon who tried to destroy Varrock 150 years ago, is back, and she can see you wielding the magic demon slaying sword Silverlight and vanquishing Delrith once again. That basically gives us the premise of the quest. We need to get the sword Silverlight and then interrupt the dark wizards just after they revive Delrith and banish him back to wherever he was. I don't know, some interdimensional prison or something. Work your way through the different narrative options. The quickest path being to select options 1, 2, and then 3. This will explain about the great hero Wally. He's the previous hero, and it's Silverlight that was his sword, that was the weapon he used to kill Delrith. Any minute now, we should get a nice little cutscene which shows us the moment that Wally defeated the demon. There's lots of detail in this. I'm kind of paraphrasing, but you know, work through the narrative at your own pace. This is the cutscene I was talking about earlier. Here's Wally, great name, and he's stabbing the demon, and then he mentions this incantation. This is a really important point, and I'm going to zoom in the screen just to kind of like emphasize that incantation is the incantation you need to remember. Everyone who does this quest will have a slightly different incantation, so do not use the one you've just seen on the screen. You need to remember yours specifically. Don't worry if you didn't capture it there at that point. The Gypsy will repeat the incantation for you shortly. When she does, you'll see that I will take a screenshot and just save that on Paint in the background. So it's really useful if you've got like a dual screen set up at this point, because you can have the incantation open next to you for reference when it comes to that battle with Delrith at the conclusion of the quest. Once the cutscene is ended, you can get a refresher of the incantation, which is what you see I do on the screen by selecting option 3. Here we go. I'm taking a screenshot of the incantation and saving it just on a Paint page, so I'll have that open in the background. This is important, as obviously the incantation is different for every player, and if you get it wrong, Delroth's HP will regenerate, so you'll have to fight him again. Following that, in order to move on, select option 4 to end the narrative. Now I need to go find the sword. Who do I need to speak to find the sword? Well, I need to head into Varrock Palace and speak to the knight Sir Prysin. Sir Prysin is the ancestor of Wally and the inheritor of the Silverlight Sword. Here he is, just to the left-hand side of the door when you walk into Varrock Palace. Speak to him. He will tell you that he's got the sword. In fact, you can actually see the sword in the top right corner of the screen there. It's in the case on the wall, and there's three locks securing it. Unfortunately, Sir Prysin is a bit of a klutz and has lost one of the keys that he was looking after. The other key is with Captain Rovin, and the third and final key is with the wizard Triborn in the Wizard's Tower. So we need to go around now and collect all three of these keys in order to collect the sword. The fastest way through the narrative is to select options 3, 1, 2, 1, 1, 3. In that order, we'll complete the narrative with Sir Prysin. Then I'm going to head to Captain Rovin, who is in the Northwest Tower of Varrock Palace. So you'll see me cut here because I got a little bit lost and I was going all over the place. You just need to head straight northwest on the ground floor and up the tower to the top of the spiral staircase. On the third floor, you'll find Captain Roven. Captain Roven is not particularly fond of Sir Prysin, as obviously Sir Prysin's a bit of a klutz, and Captain Roven is not particularly enamoured with the guy. Go through the narrative options. Eventually, once you get through each option, keep talking about the key. If you get lost, the fastest way through the narrative is to select options 3, then option 1, option 2, option 2, option 3, and finally option 1 again. Following this exchange, he will eventually give you the key, and we can carry on with the rest of the quest. Sorry, I'm a really slow reader. I think I say this in most of my quest videos. I'm an exceptionally slow reader sometimes. And I was obviously reading the dialogue as I went through. Hey, finally, we've got the first key. Head back downstairs to the first floor. The camera's cut again, because again, I kind of got lost. Now you want to head to the second floor, northern area. And there's two bedrooms here, and you can see there's a bucket in one of the bedrooms, and that's what we want. Well, actually, there's a bucket in both bedrooms, so pick a bedroom and grab a bucket. Once you've got a bucket, head down the staircase, the spiral staircase there, and you're in the kitchen. Use the bucket on the sink in order to obtain the bucket of water that we needed that I told you about at the start of the video. Once we have the bucket of water, you can see that really obvious drain outside. Use the bucket of water on the drain. Watch that guy walk past. And there we go. I've washed the key down the drain. So the key is now in the sewers. And we're going to have to go retrieve it. Head all the way back through the palace. And then head to your left as you come out. Follow my character. And you see these manhole covers. They lead to Varrock's sewers. I can show you there on the map. They're marked by the dungeon indicator. Head down there. Here we are in Varrock sewers. Directly in front of you, there's two paths. You want to take the left-hand path and just follow that straight along. Don't worry, the key is not very far and not very difficult to find. And you'll come to these, like, there's sort of zombie areas and there's a big pile of skeletons with a couple of drain pipes sticking out. And the key will just be sitting there waiting. So when you find the key, select the key. You don't need to worry about the zombies. Here I'll show you on the map, watch where the arrow goes, that is the path that you need to take, and this is where you'll find the key. That's all you need to do in this dungeon, so head straight back out. Before we go, however, for the wizard Triborn's key, we need 25 bones in order for him to do a spell to summon his key to him, because he's used the spell to like store his key. So the number of giant rats around, I just thought, they're easy to kill, this is as good a place as any to gather bones. In hindsight, it's probably a little bit quicker given that the next thing I'm going to do when I exit this dungeon is use home teleport to go to Lumbridge and then mooch from Lumbridge to the Wizard's Tower. Obviously, if you've got an Amulet of Glory and your members, you can just teleport straight to Draenor Village or the Wizard's Tower and that'll be a lot quicker. However, because I'm going to go to Lumbridge, getting bones from the goblins might have actually been quicker. But as I was already here, this is where I got the bones. It's reasonably quick. Bear with me while I slaughter some rats just to get the 25 bones we need for that spell. I'm leaving the meat. There's no benefit to bringing the meat. I've already got food for the battle with Delrith later on. That battle itself really depends on your level. If you're low level, so Delrith is level 27, I believe. If you're around the same level or lower, you probably will need the food to fight him. However, he only has around 7 hit points, so he's not massively challenging. It's probably a bigger challenge actually trying to avoid the Dark Wizards and actually get to engage Delrath in the first place. But luckily, boom, there we go. I've got a full inventory of bones. I've got the 25 bones I needed. And now we need to head to the Wizard's Tower to get the third and final key. So without having use of a proper teleport, I'm going to use the teleport home to get to Lumbridge, and then I'm going to hoof it west from Lumbridge all the way to the Wizard's Tower. As you can see, it's still the anniversary event at this point, hence all the decorations. Head directly west to the Wizard's Tower. Just as a side note, there's several quests started in the Wizard's Tower, including Rune Mysteries and Imp Catcher. I'll pop some links up on the screen there. If you haven't done either of those quests, they're reasonably easy to do, and they're definitely worth doing for some easy quest points and rewards. Okay, so here we are at the Wizard's Tower. You just need to head up the spiral staircase to the second floor. The Wizard Triborn is in the room there. You can see he's an old elderly sorcerer, and he's clearly suffering from a little bit of memory loss. He doesn't remember Sir Prysin. He thinks Silverlight's a good name for a ship, so he doesn't recognize the sword, and he doesn't really seem to get what we're talking about. In order to get him to reveal the key in the fastest way possible, select dialogue options 3, 3, and then 2. That should give us the quest to go and collect 25 bones, which, as you can see by the inventory, we've already collected. At this point, the dialogue will end. Once the dialogue's ended, because we've already got the 25 bones, immediately speak to him again, and we can start the summoning charm to get the key. Here we go, we've handed over the 25 bones. He's chanting his spell, and his cupboard appears, and he hands us a key. Excellent. So, now we've got all three keys, we can go retrieve Silverlight. Head back down the spiral staircase, and head to Draenor Bank, because I've been training my magic in the background of this, so I have Varrock teleport, so I'm going to withdraw runes and use a teleport to Varrock. If you can't do that, head to Varrock now, or buy the Chronicle from Diango, and a teleport card, and that will teleport you to the Champions Guild just south of Varrock. You've seen me do this in numerous videos. Definitely an easy way to do it if you haven't trained your magic. I have been training my magic, so I've teleported to Varrock. Now, head straight to the palace and speak to Sir Prysin. When you speak to him this time, you will kind of be sort of teleported into his room shortly. There we go. And here we'll remove Silverlight from the case and present it to you. Sweet. So we've got Silverlight. Boom. It's even sparkling. I think it'd be cool if RuneScape included that emote so that when you wielded Silverlight, you actually got access to that custom little shine emote like what you just saw. Maybe there is a way of doing that. If it is possible, please leave me a comment. Okay, so back to business. You'll see that when I took the teleport runes out, I also brought out some food. I then sort of popped to Varrock West Bank and take this kind of long meandering road round towards the stone circle. This is where you need to prep, so get your armor out, get your food, and get ready for the battle. Obviously, bring Silverlight. I'll just show you on the map quickly. You can see the stone circle directly south of Varrock. That is where Delrath is being summoned. You'll have walked past it a million times if you haven't done this quest previously, and that is where we need to go. I'll give you a quick tip that, especially for low level characters, approaching from the south is best. That's why I've kind of done this weird kind of coming around the side of Varrock, so I can come in from the south. Because when Delrith is summoned, he appears at the southern side of the stone circle. So if you're quick and you put your run on, you can charge Delrith and attack him straight away before the wizards are able to hit you with spells. It's not a multi-combat area, which is good because it would be really hard otherwise. But at the same time, it means if a wizard attacks you, it kind of locks you out and stops you from being able to attack Delrith. So, just let's refresh our memory now. I've still got my screen open. There is the incantation. So now everything's set. Because you've activated the Demon Slayer quest, when you approach the circle, you'll automatically start the Demon Slayer cutscene. So here we go. The Dark Wizards are summoning Delrith. The stone circle breaks, and out pops the demon, big bad Delrith. Luckily for Varrock, we are here to stop him. So you can see how he's hanging around in the southern area. Now, I wasn't fast enough here, but luckily for me, it doesn't really matter. So equip Silverlight, put your run on, and get to Delrith. So you can see there what I was saying about the wizards. They attacked me, which meant I was engaged with them, so I couldn't attack Delrith. I managed to sort of get them locked off behind the stone circle, which allowed the aggro to drop so I could attack Delrith. If you're a low level, ideally, you need to get in there quick, so get your rune on and just charge Delrith. The battle begins, and maybe it was misleading at the start of the video, but I one-hit Delrith with Silverlight. So now is the key part. If we get this wrong, his health will regenerate to full, and we'll have to fight him again. So let's get the first part of the incantation. In my case, I believe that was Kalem. And the second part, Camarenthium. The third part was Perchii. Fourth part was Abba. And the final part, I believe, is Gabindo. There we go. Delroth is sucked into the vortex and banished from Gelinor. Adios, amigos. Boom. So once you click the continue there, you have completed the Demon Slayer quest. You get to keep Silverlight, and you get 3 quest points. If you have enjoyed this video, and it has been at all helpful, please like, subscribe, share, and leave a comment. I, the Lumbridge Knight, am at your service. So, until the next time, fare thee well, brave adventurers.